Hello everyone, welcome to part 42 of advanced ecom series in Laravel 7. So in this video we are going to continue working on the product attributes. Okay, so in last video we able to add the product attributes. You have seen we able to add the small, medium and large sizes of product ID 1. Okay, and in this video we are going to show the product attributes here in the common page where from where we are adding the product attributes as well. Okay, so once again we will create one more relation, and now this time the relation is between the product and product attributes. Okay, so I have earlier on explained you about this thing. Okay, once again I am going to explain you. I hope that everything is clear up to now. And see, we have first created the sections, and after that we have created the categories, after that we have created the subcategories, and under subcategories we have created the products. Okay, so this is the product, and now we have created the attributes. These are the attributes like small, medium and large. Okay, so finally the thing that we are doing now, we just require create the relation between the product and the attributes. So these attributes we are talking about. Okay, these we have created. Okay, so we want to establish the relation between the product and their attributes. So the relation is like, I'm going to show you ecom. Okay, here you can see the relation will be between the product and product attributes, and one product can have many attributes. You can see yourself, one product is having the three attributes. One product can have many attributes, small, medium and large and more. Okay, so the relation is now product has many. Okay, so it clearly shows the relation this time is has many. We have done so many times. One section can has many categories, one category can has many products, and one product can has many attributes. Okay, and this attribute belongs to product. Okay, so has many and belongs to relations are the common relation of Laravel that we can use almost in every table that are connected with each other. Okay, so here we are going to create this relation in the product model. Okay, so let me open the product model and quickly create this relation. So here I will create one more relation, that is public function attributes. Okay, so this relation I am going to create now, return dollar this has many will come in this relation. Okay, so app here, what we will do, we will add products attribute this time. Okay, products attribute, see, product can has many attributes. Okay, so this one will come up here and nothing is required. Okay, so sorry, it automatically picks that ID. Okay, automatically get connected with the ID in products attributes. We are using the product underscore ID. Okay, so now we just need to connect this one in products controller. We are going to open an attribute. I'm going to open an attribute here. I can do it like this, and here I'm going to connect this one here with attributes. Okay, I attach this relation with our query, product data query, where we are fetching the product details. Now I am going to check once that what will come up here. Okay, call to undefined relation attribute, spelling attributes, attri. Make sure the spelling are correct. Attributes on app model. Seems to be correct. I am going to check why this issue is coming up. Attributes, cultural friend relationship, attributes on app product. Okay, so here I can do it like this. First of all, I'm going to check whether the command is coming up here. I want to debug this one. Okay, fine. And so here the issue is with this query. Here I'm going to do, and again it is coming like this. Okay, it seems I'm going to check it also. Now the issue is not coming. Now what is it issue? Now I'm going to check. Now the I think the it's not saved. That's why it might be issue is coming. Okay, so nothing I have done. Okay, so you can see the attributes have come up here for the product, and you can see there are all the attributes have displayed of the product ID 1. Okay, along with the product details. Okay, so now see. One more thing we need to do, we will fetch only the required details. Okay, so many details are not required, so always it is always good if you are going to fetch only the required details. So I will also use the select query here. I will just use select ID whatever I required. Okay, and we are using product name, product code, color, product name, product code, color, product price, product price we will not give, product code, product color, and after that main image also, main image, and attributes, of course attributes will be there. Okay, and then like this we can now try. Okay, now it seems to be fine. Only the required details we are fetching. Okay, so that it means look goods, because otherwise if we will fetch all the details and just only few details we are fetching, it will make the query slow, it will make our website slow, and also unwanted data will waste our time because we will get confused. Okay, so now we can just required to display. Okay, and here you can see we are fetching the details in array. Okay, this thing I have explained you in live session as well, that what is the difference between array and JSON object. And if you have not seen that live session, you can again see that session after. I will also share the link here in video itself. You can have a view of that live session, and you guys, my channel members, must always view that live session, because you can also, I will all answer your queries as well. If you have any doubt, you can ask me there as well. And so that's why you can join the Stack Developer channel and ask me your doubts. And I will also help you in your coding as well. Okay, so this one we have done. Now we just required to show the attribute details in add attributes page. So I'm going to open this one, and I want to display here my attributes. Okay, so I will add for each loop here. Okay, and I require something. I require, like, I can copy from view products, that products blade file page, because I want to show now the attributes. So I will see that I can use this one there. Okay, this is a good idea. Or I can also copy paste this one itself. Okay fine, I am going to display this one there. Okay, so let me see this one, complete div class card. Okay, I am going to display here, and see, after this one I am going to add this here, fine, yeah, like this. Okay, so here I am going to write added duck attributes. Okay, and here add product attributes come. So first I want to see as well that what is coming, but okay, let me do first here again. This one is not required, we can move this unwanted. Okay, yeah, we can move now, fine. And now we just require here like ID, site, SKU, price, okay, and after that stop. Okay, and we can also keep actions for later on. Okay, so here I am going to use this one product data once again. Product data, and I am passing the attribute, you can see here this one I am passing. So this one is the form of array, so I will just get it like this attribute, and here I'm going to use the attribute here. Okay, so as I am using the array now, it will not work, it will work like this attribute ID like this. Okay, and after that use attribute. Okay, so here we require site. Okay, after site we require SKU, and after SKU we require price, after price we require stock. Okay, so this unwanted code we can remove, and nothing to do. Okay, so rest all we can remove for now, we will see later if anything we require we can add again. Now this one is fine. Now I can check one again. I am going to refresh here, and you can see added product attributes are coming fine, and it looks really good for format. Is it's looking really nice. Okay, you can see here. Okay, so the added proc attributes are coming here. So every time if you will add some attributes, it's going to display here. Okay, make your task easier. And here also you can search even. Yeah, okay, if there are 10-15 attributes, like in some cases, like in denims, there are sizes like 26, 28, 30, 32, 34, 36, 38, 40, 42, 44. Means there are 10-15 attributes. In that case, it will really help you to search the required data, and you can add the paging is also there if the attributes list is too long. Okay, so now if you will add any attribute, like if I am going to add one attribute here, then it must dynamically come here, and it will make your task really easy. Okay, so let me add one attribute, like I'm going to add one attribute like extra large. Okay, or I will make it like X large, like this X large. Okay, so use like this PTS001 XL. Okay, and here we can even extra large, we can even give like extra large. Okay, so here the price I want to give 1310. Okay, so let me see. So if I will click on submit, you can see here we have added the attribute, and you can see here product attribute has been added successfully, and you can see here as well that the attribute has been added successfully. Okay, so up till this I think there is no issue at all. Okay, you can able to add as many attributes as you want. Okay, so let me add the attributes of some other product. Okay, so like this black casual t-shirt, I'm going to add the attribute for this one. I will just take size is small, I want to add small. All the attributes I will add together, BL0001 S. Okay, price you can see 1500 INR, and stock is 10. Okay, so one more you are going to add. So this time I'm going to add medium, and it will like BL000 okay, it is like this. Okay, 1M. Okay, so after that I'm going to add the 1610 stock once again, and one more I want to add here like large. Okay, so this time I'm going to add all the three attributes together, and we'll see that if it will allow us to add all the three attributes together. Okay, so like this 10. Now I'm going to add all the three attributes together, and let's see. I will click on submit, and you can see all the three attributes have been added successfully. Okay, so you can see here as well in products attributes. Now we have added attributes of four attributes of product ID 1 and three attributes of product ID 4, and the relation we have already defined that one product can has many attributes. So has many relation we have done for this thing. Okay, so in next video we are going to update our attributes as well, and we are going to update price and stock attributes, and these two attributes we are going to update in our next video. And these two are only required attributes that we are going to update. We are not going to update size and SKU, and for that, if in case size and SKU are wrongly added by the admin, then admin can able to delete or either disable. Okay, that thing we will give in action. Okay, and but we are going to work on update attribute for price and stock, because price and stock user can admin can update anytime, because price can vary and even stock can vary. Means might be you are having 5 stock, sometime you are having 10 stock, so stock can also vary, price can also vary. So we will give option to update these two attributes from admin panel. Okay, so that's all for now. If you have any queries, you can surely contact me in video description, just message me. Okay, and do subscribe my channel, and also join my channel. If you are really serious about to become the Laravel expert, then you can ask the person who already joined the channel and having benefit of that. Okay, so in less than $1 per month, in just few months you can be Laravel expert. Okay, so that's I think not a bad deal. Okay, so it's up to you. Even then, I'm going to help you, my friends. You can surely contact me in Facebook group as well. Okay, so I hope that everyone is having some benefit of it. Okay, so that's all for now. Have a nice time. Goodbye.